Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Natalie van der Wielen and in this movie we will show you how to use the script editor in Biolomics. It is possible to add new functionalities to Biolomics. To do so, go to the Other Tools tab and click on the button Script Editor. In this example, we will create a new script or project in Visual Basic. Enter the name of the new project and click OK. Then, in the Project Browser section, double-click on the scriptname.vb to open the project. Click on Design to build the interface for the new functionality. Here, we will add a new text box where the user can enter a value. We use the label to provide the instructions. In the Properties section, you can adapt the displayed text. We will add a button where the user can click once the value has been entered. Another label will be used to display the results. Double-click on the button to go to the code behind. We will have to provide the needed action, so we want to show the text "Welcome to Biolomics" together with the entered value. Build the project and click Start to run the script. A pop-up appears with the interface we just created. Enter the name and click on the Go button. Now you see the welcome message from Mr. Smith. When you are not familiar with scripting or you are stuck, then you can use the debug function. Put breakpoints within your script and go step by step through the lines and see the output of each line. Use the buttons in the ribbon on top to jump from breakpoint to breakpoint or to step into or over a given action or line. To save or share a script, click on the File tab. There you can import projects made by others, as well as creating a button in the main window. Select your script from the list and update the project properties on the right. Decide where the button should be placed, give it a name and tooltip, and choose a nice picture to recognize it easily. When you are done, click Save. When we now go back to the main window of Biolomics and we go to the tab Scripts, we can see our newly created script. Click on the script to run it.